Okay, sir.
Okay, so I welcome you all to the next session of Dr. Miklesh. It's about RStudio and particularly for finance for RStudio. Over to you, Miklesh.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Is it visible, sir?
Yes, Miklesh, it's visible.
Okay. Good evening all. Actually, as I mentioned in the morning, related with the title as well as the topics with finance. So the first thing is we have to understand the nature of time series, because majority of the time, the moment you talk about research or maybe any particular project, we apply on the data set that may be related with either time series or maybe the panel data. So with that particular respect, I'd like to discuss about this time series. Just a second, sir. Okay. I think students have already gone through some intro part of RStudio. So simply, I'd like to describe in a very few minutes related with time series data, and then I'll go with RStudio. The moment you talk about time series, first and foremost, I think students are aware with time series and panel data. I'm clarifying in a jiffy, and then we'll go to RStudio.
Okay.
So any particular data which is having like observation, especially in equal interval, that is known as time series. And generally, the best example is all about we discuss in terms of a stock market. So a stock market, the information of a stock market is given in equal interval in a very like chronological order. So that's why that is known as time series data. Either that may be the daily, maybe weekly, or maybe monthly or yearly. Sometimes what happens is students get confused in terms of like the moment you discuss, he said, this is in a same data set. Let's suppose I have the data set of stock market. Some data are in daily nature or of daily nature, some of are monthly nature, and some of are yearly nature in a same file of a same series. That cannot be called time series. One of the basic assumptions is whatever data you have, that has to be in equal interval. So that is best example of time series. Now, I hope students have RStudio.
Yes, Miklesh, I hope so. I took a session on R and RStudio, and I told them how to download the T-Series package.
Okay. So, can I start this T-Series package, sir?
Yeah, you can start.
Okay. I have shared some file also on your mail, just I think before 20 minutes ago. I think, 20 minutes back, I sent you a file.
Okay.
On the same file, I'll be just showing the how to apply that particular file and what the things which required for time series. Okay. So
Miklesh, we are able to see your PPT.
I think RStudio is not being shown.
No. No.
Okay.
So maybe you need to actually what happens when you open any other software, share is disconnected. So you need to unshare and then again share.
Okay. Is it okay, sir? Now?
Yeah, now we can see you.
Okay.
So this always happens when we switch from one software to another. So share doesn't work there. Then we need to disconnect and again share.
Now I think it is being shown.
Yeah, it's shown. It's visible.
Okay. Yes, so I have shared a file related with time series, and that is in form of Excel. So that is related with Mint. Well, I think it is being shown, sir.
Yes, we can see that.
Yeah. So actually, the moment to talk about the data set that is of Mint, and that is it means Mexico, Indonesia, then Nigeria, Turkey, and then BSE that is of India. And the same file I have shared to the students, to you, sir. So okay. I hope in case of any doubt, a student can discuss about this thing. Early in the morning, one of the students asked, sir, I'd like to examine the trend of my data set. And that may be the trend related with like, so first and foremost, as students are aware that we are supposed to, after uploading the file, we are supposed to attach the file. After attaching, this file is being now it's ready. So if students have already uploaded or you can say installed this T-series package, they simply either we write require or library and then T-series. Now, after this T-series package, there is plot, or rather we say plot.ts. So this plot.ts command helps to understand the trend, either any particular series has deterministic trend or stochastic trend. I'll be talking about what is difference between this deterministic and stochastic trend. So the plot.ts and any particular variable like Mexico I write here, and then enter. I found if I press on zoom, I find this trend. So this trend, now one of your objective, if any student has the objective, is to check the trend of any particular data set, then one can apply and see. So this will be helping to understand the trend of any particular data set. It reflects this trend is a stochastic trend. Now I'd like to differentiate between a stochastic trend and deterministic trend. The best example to understand is a simple Ludo. Let's suppose if I throw a dice, I don't know what will happen. Either there may be the probability of coming 6, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, whatever. So the moment we don't know what will happen or what the number will I'll be getting. It means in a crux, we say the change is not known. Whatever the value is being changing, we don't know. So that is a stochastic trend. Like the best example is stock market, and this is also the example of a stock market. So this trend is a stochastic trend. In real world, to what I have observed, majority of the things are a stochastic trend. But we have to, apart from this, we have to also understand about deterministic trend. Deterministic trend means like change is known. If I say today the market will go up by 30%, tomorrow it will be also going by 30%, the day after tomorrow that will be also going by 30%. It means the change is known. Yes, this time 30%, tomorrow is also 30%, which is not possible in current juncture. So in a nutshell, we say the trend, like here, we find from here, and then again the value is like this, coming down, just going up, up and going down. It means if you see the series is changing, and the change we don't know at the time of getting the data set. So that is known as this stochastic trend. I hope it is okay.
Yeah, it's perfectly okay.
Yeah, in case of any doubt, a student can just discuss about this thing. So sure. One of the objectives may be filled up with the help of this stochastic and deterministic trend. So rest of the data set, we can also practice. If students want, they can practice after this session also. Now, like another issue, it happens in case of testing the, I think students have idea regarding how to descriptive statistic. I think, sir, aapne kara hi diye honge.
Yes, they know about the mean variations, etc. They know.
Yes. So now another thing is generally in time series and panel data, basically as in cross-sectional data, we discuss about so many things related with this normality. But in time series, we discuss about either the data is normally distributed or not. It does not matter. But our data has to be stationary. So now I'm going to discuss about how to test stationarity, because every test in time series or maybe in panel data depends on stationarity. So I'll be talking about this thing. So before stationarity, majority of the time, a student say, sir, I have calculated this. I have got the data set that may be in form of index, but this index, there are so many literature also, they say that we have to work on the return rather than the index. So we can calculate return also. Like, let's suppose this is the data set of Mexico stock exchange. If I want to calculate return, log return, generally we discuss about log return. So simply I write here like R Mexico equal to diff log and then Mexico and then enter. The moment I press on enter, what I found there is a series has been created, that is of R Mexico. So this R Mexico is nothing but return on Mexico, and this return is what? Log return. Basically, when you talk about log return, I think we teach the students that simply we say log and P1 upon PO. I hope students are getting who have opted the finance. So this this is the calculation of log return. So generally this P on means what? The price of if I say the day one and then PO, it means last day, we can say. So generally, if I say log P1, or we can also write for that like log P1 minus log PO, that may be also, it can be also written like this. So the crux of this is found in terms of this. So that's why log we say difference, and what difference of log and the series, and finally we find the log return of any particular series. So that's why we say this is the formula. Now the another when you see the nature of data set, or when you see with the same plot.ts, I write here plot.ts, and if I write here R Mexico, enter. Now this time the trend is something different. I hope everyone is getting.
Yeah, it's visible.
Yeah. So now the trend is something different. Trend is something different in the sense that that was the same data set, but earlier it was of price. Now it is of return. So the if you see this data set, or you can say a little bit, when you see the data set of like this price, the price data set is like this. Huge variation, large variation in this particular. When you see the trend, you find the huge variation in this particular data set. But again, if I talk about return, there is a little bit large, or we can't say there is large variation because of converting it into log return. So what is the crux of this particular discussion? The crux of this particular discussion in finance area, there is Campbell. So Campbell is one of the great contributors in form of finance. He clearly mentioned that if the price is given, generally on that particular time, we are supposed to consider return, because return is smoothened, and you can say return is strengthened compared to price, and price is more noisy. That's why we are supposed to work on return. Now, as I mentioned, stationarity, because I said in time series, either the data is normally distributed or not, it does not matter. But what has to be there? Stationarity has to be there. So stationarity is only the parameter that determines which test will be applied. So let's talk about this stationarity. Simply, okay, stationarity in one sentence, it says that stability in the parameter. Stability in the parameter means, let's suppose I have the data set. In this case, I have the data set of generally 1990. It means 1,990 observations are there. That has been clearly mentioned here in terms of 19990. We are having so many options for checking that. One of is this. Now the question is, the minimum value is 31740. First quartile is this. So this is all about the descriptive statistic, which I think students have already understood. if I make two category of this 1990, or maybe four category. Let's suppose I categorize into two parts. So the mean of first part, let's suppose I contribute here, let's suppose two categories of entire data set. If I categorize in two parts, the mean of first part and the mean of second part has to be equal. If the data set is like that, we say this data is stationary. I hope a student is clear about this.
Yeah, it's clear, but on what basis we will divide it into two parts?
Okay. Now the question is, either you divide two parts, four parts, it does not matter. This is a kind of example. Example in the sense that either you divide two parts, four parts, 10 parts, it does not matter. But the matter is what? The first part or the mean of first, variance of first will be equal to rest of the parts. If the data set is having like this nature, then we say the data is stationary. Now the question is, on which part we say? Basically, in time series, we forecast. Forecast in the sense that, let's suppose up to 2020, February, the data set is having this nature. On the basis of that trends, we are supposed to forecast for maybe next year, maybe next month. So in this case, what happens, our basis will be, if the data set is of 1 year, then let's divide into year wise. What happens for this, if the mean and variance is equal, it means we say my data is stationary. If I say my data is stationary, only then we can say that this data is forecastable. Otherwise, data cannot be forecasted. Hello.
Yeah, got it. Makes sense.
So, yeah. Now the question is, another question is also, when you go in detail, in Gujarati, it has been clearly mentioned in book of Gujarati, that is in econometrics. There is no concept of population and this sample in time series. Rather, we talk about realization. So whatever data we have, we discuss about the entire things are realized value. So now I'm just moving how to test, but here, thanks to different software, we are not supposed to categorize the entire data set in different categories. Simply, we can check either our data is stationary or not with the help of so many tests. And one of the tests is ADF test, that is very famous in terms of augmented Dickey-Fuller test. So the moment, actually this ADF test comes under T-series package. That's why before applying this ADF test, we are supposed to install as well as load it in library, that is of T-series package. And then only then we can get this ADF dot test facility. So the moment I write here ADF dot test, and then let's suppose I write here Mexico, and then enter. Now, this is the result. And simply, what is our null hypothesis? Here, our null hypothesis is Mexico is non-stationary. Mexico has presence of unit root, because non-stationary is also known as unit root. It means here, I hope students are already having idea regarding acceptance and rejection of hypothesis.
Dr. Miklesh, there is a query from Akash. He is asking if you can elaborate once again about what this ADF is used for.
Okay. Actually, ADF test is used. Sir, has he shared on Zoom itself? Yeah. I hope, am I audible?
Yes, you are audible.
Basically, ADF test is applied. ADF test is applied to check or examine the stationarity in the series. Now, why I'm talking about series? Majority of the time, in time series, let's suppose Mexico or maybe Indonesia, Nigeria, or any particular, maybe the Turkey. Rather than saying variable, we say series because this is of time series nature. So that's why I have mentioned here. We can write the variable also, but most appropriate term is series. So I have clearly mentioned here, this ADF test is applied to check stationarity in a series. It means here, testing the stationarity will help us which test in later part, maybe today or maybe if time will be permitted any other day, then I'll be discussing about in which condition, what type of test will be applied. And this is the criteria through which test is applied. So here, p value is greater than 5%, 0.05. So what we say, our null hypothesis is accepted. This is the p-value is greater than 0.05. It means our null hypothesis. What is our null hypothesis? The null hypothesis is this series, Mexico, is non-stationary. So what we say? We say this Mexico is non-stationary series. It means this Mexico has presence of unit root. It simply means this. If I apply any particular thing or any particular test on this Mexico, it means I won't be able to forecast correctly. So what is the better option? Better option is, now the question is, if any particular series does not come stationarity, it does not mean, sir, we have collected the data set and the stationarity is not coming. Should I drop that variable or not? We are not supposed to do any particular thing. Simply, we are supposed to convert non-stationary into stationary. And the one of the best solution is differencing. And differencing means what? One of the method is converting R Mexico. Remember, I mentioned about R, how to calculate return. We found here difference. So now I have created another variable that is of return on Mexico, right? So now let's talk about, I'm going to apply on return, ADF.test, R Mexico, enter. Look, the moment we see p-value, now p-value is less than 0.05. And we say the series is like, the series is stationary. Which series? R Mexico. It means return on Mexico. Earlier was, it was price. It means earlier it was stock index. Now the same stock index has been converted into return. So we say, this is stationary, but which stationary, we have converted it into return. I hope it is making some sense.
Yeah, it's clear now.
This is the reason Campbell clearly mentioned price is more noisy. Better to work on return, because return most of the time it gives stationarity. And another example, even on this time series plot, if I zoom it, we can also check from this plot. If you see here, most of the time, if I divide, like I'm going to, if I divide two parts from this to this and this to this, most of the chance it seems the mean of first part and mean of second part will be equal, because the this such type of data set is known as mean reversion process. It means it is coming to near to its mean. Why we require a stationarity in any particular series. I hope it is okay, sir.
Yeah, it's okay. Actually, even I don't know how much these students know about these basic.
Hello.
Hello. Hi, Miklesh.
Yeah, it is okay, sir.
Yeah, it's okay. I was just saying that even I don't know how much the students know about these concepts, but the time is only for 4 more minutes we have. So, Miklesh, one thing, like you said at one point, that can you please unshare?
Pardon?
Can you please unshare?
Okay, unshare.
Stop share.
Oh, sir. Yes, sir.
I think that in one point you mentioned that we should know where to apply which particular test or technique. Like first you should check for the unit root, and then you go ahead with which test or technique should apply. So can we request you to take a session on that, or like just a summary of that, which particular tool or technique to apply?
Okay. So should I continue right now?
Right now it's only 3 minutes are there. I don't know how much we will be able to cover.
Yes, it becomes difficult in this 3 minutes. So yeah. Maybe I think in next session I can discuss about this, in which condition which test will be applied, because there are so many tests, maybe in terms of Johansson co-integration, then time series integration, VAR, VCM. There are so many tests which are applicable in case of time series. Yes. And apart this, there is also the case of panel data, maybe in terms of so many tests are there.
Okay.
So next I can discuss about this.
Can we have a session tomorrow if you are comfortable anytime tomorrow?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. No problem, sir.
Okay. So at what time it will be comfortable to you?
Sir, as per your comfort level, sir.
Okay. I will talk to Dr. Firoz and then I will let you know. And about the
Okay, sir. Okay. What happens? Sir, I have already shared, uploaded the this test of stationarity on my YouTube channel also.
Yes.
So students, if they want, they can go.
Right.
I'll share the PPT also, which I have discussed right now.
Right. So I will share your the files you have sent to me. I will share those files, and plus I will share all sort of the YouTube links, and I will request students to please go through them today itself, so that tomorrow, let's have 10 a.m. will be okay to you.
Yes, sir.
So 10 a.m. we can have this session, and I will request all the students to first go through all sort of your videos, and I will send the data file also, and then they will be in a better position. So there was a request from Akash that if you can share the list of the tests, just if you are sending any PPT, that's fantastic, or the list of the tests, so that they know that these are the things we will discuss about.
Okay. Okay. No issue, sir.
Okay. Shall you? Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Miklesh, for taking some time. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.